Hello everyone, I am Dr. Palak Jain, currently working with Dinanath Mangeshkar Hospital, Pune. I'll be discussing with you today composition of some commonly used IV fluids. The IV fluids can be divided into isotonic, hypotonic and hypertonic fluids. Isotonic fluids have osmolality which is similar to plasma, that is 275 to 295 milliosmoles per liter. To name a few of the isotonic IV fluids, we have 0.9% NS, we have Ringer's lactate, we have dextrose 5%, and we have isolite P. Hypotonic fluids such as 0.45 NS, they have an osmolality of less than 270 milliosmoles per liter, and hypertonic fluids have an osmolality of more than 300 milliosmoles per liter, as in case of 3% NaCl. Starting with the sodium-containing preparations, the commonly used sodium-containing preparations are 0.9% normal saline, 0.45% normal saline, Ringer's lactate, isolite P, and 3% NaCl. 0.9% normal saline have 154 milliequivalents per liter of sodium and 154 milliequivalents per liter of chloride with an osmolality of 308 milliosmoles per liter, while 0.45% normal saline has exact half of these, that is 77 milliequivalents per liter of sodium, 77 milliequivalents per liter of chloride, and 154 milliosmoles per liter of osmolality. Ringer's lactate has 130 milliequivalent sodium and 109 milliequivalent chloride. It also has 4 milliequivalents per liter of potassium. The osmolality of Ringer's lactate is 261 milliosmoles per liter. Isolite P has 30 milliequivalents per liter of sodium and 20 milliequivalents per liter of potassium with an osmolality of 300 milliosmoles per liter. 3% NaCl has 513 milliequivalents per liter each of sodium as well as chloride. And the osmolality is 1026 milliosmoles per liter. As is evident from this slide, 0.9% normal saline, Ringer's lactate and isolite P. These three sodium containing preparations are isotonic preparations. 0.45% normal saline has osmolality which is less than 270 milliosmoles per liter, so it's the hypotonic fluid. And 3% NaCl has 1026 milliosmoles per liter osmolality, so this one is a hypertonic fluid. Coming to the potassium containing preparations, the commonly available ones are potassium chloride and potassium phosphate. Potassium chloride, 1 ml of potassium chloride contains 2 milliequivalents of potassium. It is used as an additive in dextrose 5% and dextrose 10% when these fluids are used as maintenance fluid. The daily requirement of potassium is 2 to 4 milliequivalents per kg per day. Potassium chloride is also used for the treatment of hypokalemia at a dose of 0.5 to 1 milliequivalents per kg IV over 1 hour. While giving it in through peripheral venous access, we have to dilute the total fluid to a concentration of 40 milliequivalents per liter. While if we have a central venous access, we can use concentrations of up to 60 to 80 milliequivalents per liter. The second commonly available potassium preparation is potassium phosphate, where 1 ml of potassium phosphate contains 4.4 milliequivalents of potassium. It is used for the treatment of hypokalemia as described above, as well as for hypophosphatemia. Third in line is the dextrose-containing preparations. The commonly available dextrose-containing preparations are 5% dextrose, 10% dextrose, 25% dextrose, and 50% dextrose. 5% dextrose, as the name suggests, will contain 50 grams per liter of glucose in water and has an osmolality of 278 milliosmoles per liter. Same is the case with 10% dextrose, it will contain 100 grams per liter of glucose and will have an osmolality of 505 milliosmoles per liter. 25% dextrose contains 250 grams per liter of glucose and has an osmolality of 1389 milliosmoles per liter. And 50% dextrose contains 500 grams per liter of glucose. These are the commonly available preparations. If we need any other dextrose concentration other than these formulations, we have to prepare by mixing two dextrose concentrations. How to prepare the desired dextrose concentration? We have this formula, which is H minus D divided by H minus L multiplied by the volume that has to be prepared. So where H is the highest available dextrose concentration, L is the lowest available dextrose concentration, and D is the desired dextrose concentration. For example, if 100 ml of dextrose 20% needs to be prepared from dextrose 25% and dextrose 5%, the formula to be applied is H minus D upon H minus L into volume to be prepared. So the highest concentration that we have with us is 25, and the desired concentration is 20% divided by the highest available concentration, which is 25, minus the lowest available concentration, which is 5, and multiplied by the volume of volume to be prepared, which is 100 ml in this example. So it comes out to be 5 into 100 divided by 20, which comes out to be 25. So we have to take 25 ml of dextrose 5% plus 75 ml of, but the remaining amount, that is 75 ml of dextrose 25%. This is a chart that shows the commonly desired concentrations and how to prepare it. Like dextrose 7.5% can be prepared by adding 12.5 ml of dextrose 25% in 87.5 ml of dextrose 5%. Similarly, for dextrose 12.5%, dextrose 15%, dextrose 17.5%, and dextrose 20%. So the choice of fluid depends on the indication for which we are giving the fluid. If we need a fluid for replacement of losses, then we can use 0.8% NS and Ringer's lactate, because these two have electrolytes as well as they are isotonic to the plasma. The commonly used maintenance fluid are dextrose 5%, as is used in extreme preterm units or extremely low birth weight units. Dextrose 10% and isolite P. While for hyponatremia, the available preparations are 0.9% NS, CRL, and 3% NSA. Coming to the IV infusion sets, there are two types of infusion sets that are available: macro drip set and micro drip set. The macro drip set contains no internal drip needle, while a micro drip set contains an internal drip needle. Macro drip set, depending on the manufacturer, the 1 ml will make either 10, 15, 20, or 30 drops of fluid, while a micro drip set, all micro drip sets, 1 ml will make 60 drops. Macro drip sets are used to push larger amount of fluids over a shorter period of time, example during resuscitation, while a micro drip set is used for more precise fluid administration. It is difficult to titrate the exact amount of fluid which is entering the patient because of the large amount that gets pushed over a shorter duration of time with a macro drip set. But in a micro drip set, the slower drop rates prevent over administration of fluids. How to calculate drip rate? Drip rate, which is calculated in drops per minute, is calculated by volume to be infused in milliliters into multiplied by drop factor divided by time over which the volume needs to be infused into 60. So for example, if 250 ml is to be infused over 24 hours using a micro drip set, the drip rate will be volume to be infused, which is 250 ml. The drop factor, as we are using micro drip set, the drop factor is 60 divided by the time. Since this 250 ml needs to be infused over 24 hours, the time is 24 into 60. So 250 into 60 divided by 24 multiplied by 60 will become 10 drops per minute. So checklist before administering any of the IV fluids. We have to ensure a closed loop communication between doctor and the nursing staff. There has to be a written order from the doctor. We have to check the fluid bag. The staff needs to check the fluid bag or bottle for expiry date, as well as for the presence of any sediments or fungal elements. All IV fluids need a label, The label should contain the patient name, date, time, the type of fluid which is used, the rate of fluid administration, and any additives if there are added in the fluids. Like in dextrose 5% and dextrose 10%, after 48 hours of life, we start adding electrolytes in the form of CRL and K-Sol. So we have to write the additives there. Label should be signed by both the staff who prepared as well as checked the fluid. And all IV fluids should be counter-checked by a third person. Thank you.